Good morning everybody. So this is the first video for circulatory system, that is the third topic of the chapter life process we have initiated. So when we talk about circulatory system, basically we are talking of a life process that will help in the transportation of essential items from one place to other place of the body. When we talk about unicellular organism, please remember their entire body is in direct contact with the outer environment, so they do not require a proper differentiated organ system that can help in the circulation. But in multicellular organisms like us, we need a proper transport system. So in this topic we are going to understand about the circulatory system in human, and then we will compare it with the circulatory or transport system in plants. So when we talk about circulatory system in humans, basically the things that it is needed to transport is basically the respiratory gases, the hormones, the nutrient that has been absorbed, and different other kinds of materials like which has to be ingested out. So it will consist of a fluid connective tissue like blood and lymph. Blood is again redivided into blood plasma and the different cells which are components of it. The blood plasma will mainly have water, ions like calcium, potassium, etc., and proteins like fibrin, fibrinogen, prothrombin, and many more. The cells will be RBC, which is also known as erythrocytes, having hemoglobin that helps in the transportation of respiratory gases. WBCs are also known as leukocytes that helps in providing the immunity to the body. Platelets are not exactly cells, but they are the fragments of cells, and these thrombocytes, which are the platelets, also helps in blood clotting. The lymph, which is again an extracellular fluid connective tissue, it is very similar to blood, but here the plasma of this lymph will have comparatively less amount of protein. Also, it will neither have the RBC or the platelets, it will only be consisting of WBC. The network system will consist of arteries, veins, and capillaries to carry the blood, and there will be many lymph capillaries or lymph node to carry the lymph fluid. Human heart as pumping organ we are going to understand, and for repair blood clotting factor we will understand over here. Now in artery, you can know that we have done in arteries basically carry oxygenated blood. This is an artery. Okay, you can see it is branching and rebranching to form one cell thick structures. These are the capillaries. It again joins and forms the veins that are only carrying what? Deoxygenated blood. Now, if I need to compare between them, we need to understand the first point is that artery will carry oxygenated blood and the veins will carry deoxygenated blood. Arteries have a very thick wall that causes high blood pressure of the blood flowing inside. Compared to this, veins have comparatively thin wall and less blood pressure will be there inside it. Because high blood pressure is present inside the artery to the blood which is flowing over here, it will never have a chance to again backflow, so no valves are present over here. But in the case of veins, there is always a chance that it may backflow, and that is why veins are consisting having the valves. Veins are superficial in nature, but arteries are deep seated because the oxygenated blood has to be prevented from any kind of injury. Capillaries are more or less one cell thick. It is one cell thick so that it can make the flow of or respiratory gases exchange between direct cells. So from now, all the videos will come into your topic. Thank you.